As scientists trying to get to the truth in whatever matter we're studying, it's critical that we're really conscious about these sources of bias. We have outcomes that we often hope to see from an experiment, and it's critical that when we're taking measurements, we do so in a way with all the checks in place to make sure that with that bias that we have doesn't creep into the resulting data.
If the experimenter is having a bias in how they are collecting the data, treating the samples, in a way, that is a confounding variable because it is a factor that is differing from sample to sample. That is, your technique or your attention to detail or your level of criticality is varying from sample to sample in a way that you are not controlling for. So the presence of your bias can also confound your results. So if you see something that's different between two treatments, you won't know whether it's real biology or if it's because you were being biased.
I think the key thing to mention here is that probably in most cases, bias is unintentional, meaning that experimenter is really trying to do it right, but there are choices that the experimenter is making that are not allowing kind of a neutral type of measurement.
If you're aware of your own bias, then you can integrate that into your experiment to have an experimental design that is less biased and more approximates better the truth. So for example, if you know you'll be excited about a given result and not excited about another result, and you're scoring a phenotype, you're gonna be more likely to score, to find and see the exciting phenotype than the phenotype that is less exciting. So a good way of designing an experiment to control for that is to do blind scoring. So if you do blind scoring, particularly double blind scoring, where even the person that is helping you do the blind scoring doesn't know what the different experimental systems are, then you're able to, in an unbiased fashion, score the phenotypes without influencing the outcome of the experiment. Blinding is when the experimenter doesn't know what they're scoring. They know how to score, but they don't know how that relates to the different experimental variables that they're testing.
Imagine that you are studying how a particular mutation affects tumor growth. So you will have two populations of cells, the cancer cells, and the cancer cells with that particular mutation that you have introduced in vitro in the lab. So then you go into mice and you introduce those two populations of cells. It's possible that that mutation increases or decreases the tumor growth. You can have your evidence suggesting that it's going to be one thing or the other. But the best way to not be biased towards one outcome is to just be blind when you are monitoring the tumor growth in those mice. With this, I mean to label those mice with numbers, not calling them wild type and mutant or this particular cell line and this mutation in this particular gene. Just a number, and often actually having someone else, not yourself, measuring those tumors will help you to be blind in this experiment if that person doesn't know which mice were injecting which cells.
In this case, you're extracting the bias because you cannot have a bias when you don't know what you're looking at and it's random. But that only comes if you recognize that that bias is there. So that's why it's important to recognize that those biases are inherent and then design experiments that account for those biases rather than say, I'm gonna get to a point where I'm not biased about this and then I'm gonna score it. That doesn't work.